Step 1, update and install dependencies. To update and install dependencies, you can run the following commands in Tmux. Now install Tmux X11 repo package. Install the other important packages by running this following command. Step 2, install Debian. To install Debian and set up Kali Linux, follow these steps. Log into the Debian environment. Update Debian and install necessary packages. Add a new username Kali. Now set up password for user Kali. Fill the other details like full name and hit enter to save, then press E to confirm. Edit the sudoers file to grant sudo access to the user Kali. Add the following line to the file. By pressing Ctrl O, hit Enter, and then press Ctrl X to exit the Nano Editor. Now exit from root account and log into the Debian environment as the user Kali with shared temporary directory. This command comes with an error because there was a space in it. Let's log in again with user Kali. Debian login is successful. Let's add Kali repository to Debian. Add the following lines to end of the file to add Kali repositories. To save the changes, press Ctrl O, hit Enter, and then press Ctrl X to exit the Nano Editor. If you encounter any error problems, you can try importing the GPG key feed for the Kali Linux repositories. Enter your sudo password to save your GPG keys. Once GPG key updated, update your Kali using apt update command. Now we will install Kali Linux XSS desktop environment using Kali desktop XSE command. It will take some time to install, depends on your device performance and your internet connection. It will ask you to select your keyboard. I am going to select English keyboard. Now exit from current user using exit command and then install Debian XSE file from GitHub link in Termux. Open the script using the NanoText editor. Replace the Droid Master username with your own username. Once done, save the changes. By pressing Ctrl O, hit Enter, and then press Ctrl X to exit the Nano Editor. Rename the script to xfce.sh by running the following command. Make the script executable. To create a shortcut command for starting the XFCE desktop environment, create kix file using the Nano Editor. Enter the following line. Save the changes by pressing Ctrl O, hit Enter, and then press Ctrl X to exit the Nano Editor. Make the kix file executable by running the following command. You should already download Termux X11 to proceed with Termux GUI mode. Now you can see Kali Linux is running in GUI mode using ProDistro. You can install all Kali packages without any error. Using same method, you can install Kali Linux with GNOME. You just need to install GNOME file from GitHub. It comes with pre-installed Firefox. Using Termux X11 app is more faster than VNC Viewer. You can see system info here and Pulse Audio also working. Ipoo can play audio files. This Firefox comes with Kali bookmarks. I hope you like this method. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button below for more content like this. If you have any questions or suggestions for future videos, let us know in the comments section below. And lastly, if you found this video helpful, consider sharing it with your friends.